Welcome back to my channel again. Today I'm going to do presentation on project called microwave oven simulation. First of all, I would like to thank Emmertech for providing me a internship on embedded systems. Let's go for project presentation. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Bhanu Teja K and I am from Government Engineering College, Uvina, Hadagali, and I am studying in fourth year of electronics and communication branch. The things we are going to discuss in this presentation are: what is microwave oven, requirements, what is embedded system, a brief information about microcontroller and microprocessor, and TXMLab, PLCD, matrix keypad, IRC, timers, and finally we are going to implement a project demo in TXMLab simulator. Let's see. What is microwave oven? Microwave oven is used to heat or cook the food using microwaves, which is off from electromagnetic waves. Means these microwaves are generated from electromagnetic waves. There are several modes in microwave oven. We are going to discuss a basic four modes of microwave oven. First one, microwave mode. Second one, grill mode. Third one, conventional mode. Fourth one, start mode. In micro mode, it is an traditional way of cooking a food and it consumes 900 watts of power, and we can set our timer up to 60 minutes. The 60 minutes is the maximum time we can set it in micro mode. If we want to cook a food, we have to set the timer between 0 to 60 minutes. Second one, grill mode. This mode is used to cook a meat or a bread. A main purpose of this mode is to cook a meat, and in this mode user can set a time up to where the food has to be cooked at a certain temperature. Third one is conventional mode. In this conventional mode, the user sets a temperature or decides a temperature at which the food has to be cooked and leaves 3 minutes for a preheat. After that preheating, the user sets a timer to cook or heat a food as per the requirement. Let us discuss what are the requirements we need to build this microwave oven. First one, we should be well knowledge in embedded systems, and we must have idea about how to use MATLAB. We must have idea how to use MPLAB IDE platform, and our system must consist of X68 compiler, which is supportable file for MPLAB IDE to run our C code, and we need a TXMLab in which we are going to use PIC16F877A microcontroller, 16x4 TLCD, tactical switches, matrix keypad, and a timer. Let's see a basics of embedded system. First of all, we will go through what is embedded system. Embedded system is a combination of hardware and software which is or joined or together to do a specific task which are given to a mission. There are two types of missions or a system. One is general purpose systems, which is used to perform a large number of tasks, and embedded system, which are used only where the specific task has to be done at a specific time and a specific work has to be done. The types of embedded systems are standalone system, real-time system, network system, and mobile system. Let's briefly discuss about these systems. First one, standalone system. Basically, the standalone system says that it works on the code which we are inserted, which are embedded with a machine. In this standalone system, here comes with a two different types. One is slave system and another is independent system. In slave system, the slave embedded systems are meant to be work only on the code which we are dumped in a board or on a microcontroller. These systems does not have any intelligence or any idea to take the actions according to the situations. Another here comes with independent systems. These systems are well-knowledged and they have their ability to take the own decisions at a right time. The best example for this is Google car or a driverless car. These systems, these independent systems of embedded system consist of a smart intelligent system which it has a brain. Means it can think at an instant and it give a output according to the time. The best example for slave systems are semi-automated washing machine. It just wash a cloth, but it doesn't check the fabric, which type of fabric it consists. Does it have hot water or a cold water, or the engine getting heating, or the machine getting heating or not. It doesn't think about anything. Just once a switch is on, it continuously goes on run. If we consist of it in an embedded system, it depends upon the situation. It changes its actions just on the situation. If the machine gets heated, it will stop the working or it will try to cool the system, as well as it does the works according to the system runs. Next, we will see about real-time systems. These are the time-bounded systems which will take action on a specific time. There is no failure, means the failure chances are very less, because the name indicates that real-time systems means at a specific time at which the system has to be worked, it will work on that specific time. It never fails as per 99%. Next, we will see about network systems. Network system are the type of system which are connected to the internet, or we can tell to a network. It connected to a network. The best example for is home automation or home security systems. These are connected to the network and the servers. We can access them from anywhere from the world. And next type systems are mobile systems. These are a type of systems which we can carry with us throughout the world. The best examples are robots. And sometimes we can say that our laptops and as well as mobile phones. These are also a type of an embedded system where the hardware and the software are included, and as well as they have smart thinking system. So we can include those in these systems also. Now let's see about the architecture of an embedded system. Mainly the embedded system consists of CPUs, means central processing unit, and it is adjointed with our memories, actuators, sensors, diagnostic ports, which are always take our diagnostics of and all the adjacent attached systems around the CPU, and as well as it has some auxiliaries just like power and cooling system, and as well as it must contain a software which is the head of all the systems, which makes all the systems which are attached to the CPU. Let's see which type of embedded system we mostly prefer. Low power consumption, cost efficiency, efficient using of processing power. It means it has a high processing power and with accuracy and reliability, as well as efficient using of memory. It means that it doesn't store any junk value which can use a lot of memory. Let's see about controllers and processors. Here we go with microcontrollers and microprocessors. These are an integrated circuit which is capable of being programmed to perform specific tasks. It has a design restriction such as memory, size, input and output capabilities, peripherals of a function. And the choosing of microcontroller or microprocessor is purely based on applications, performance, price, availability of tools and specific abilities which can be done with a controller or a processor as per our requirement. What is the main difference between microcontroller and microprocessor? Microcontroller It consists of all components which are embedded in a single silicon chip, and they are less flexible and less design complexity. But as a microprocessor, it consists of all assembled parts separately. Thus, processor must be connected with input, output devices, and memory units. These are more flexible, but the design complexity is very more. Let's start to discuss about project. The project peripherals are PiXMLab architecture. Here we are going to discuss about a microcontroller which we are used in this board. That is PIC16F877A microcontroller. It consists of LEDs, buzzers, keypads, SSDs, matrix keypads, LCDs, RS32A, and input and output pins. And it also consists of I2C and EEPROM. And it consists of LM35 temperature sensor. Let's discuss a small concept about shrinking and sourcing type of circuits. Here, the left side lies a sourcing circuit and right side lies a shrinking circuit. The sourcing circuit, the name itself indicates that the power is going towards a load. The power is going towards the load from the microcontroller or a microprocessor. The shrinking itself indicates that the power is coming from the load. It means the power is getting down. In sourcing circuit, the load is directly connected to a ground and the power is consuming from a microprocessor. Whereas in shrinking circuit, the load is directly connected to a microcontroller or a microprocessor. The power is directly coming from a source to a microcontroller through a load. Let's see which type of CLCD we use. CLCD stands for character liquid crystal display. It means it can display a characters and it is a liquid crystal type of display. In PIXIM laboratory, there are two types of displays. First one is 16x2 display and 16x4 display. And these displays are used to display the ASCII characters or some special types of characters. These are commonly used displays, and these displays have the two types of communication modes. One is 8-bit communication mode and another is 4-bit communication mode. Let's briefly see about our tactical switches. Tactical switches. These are the type switches which acts as a register circuits. Let's see. In these switches, there are two types of circuits on which they work. First one is pull down register circuit. Second one is pull up register circuit. Whereas in pull down register circuit, the register is connected to a ground. Whereas in pull up register circuit, the register is connected to a source. In a pull down register circuit, when switch is on open state, the microcontroller doesn't get any power. When switch is in on state, the power directly flows to a microcontroller. Whereas in pull up register circuit, when a switch is turned off or turned on a off state, the current supply or a voltage supply which is connected is directly supplies to the ground. When the switch is in off state, the VDD or the current supply which is directly goes to a microcontroller. Let's see some points about our tactical switches. Tactical switch is a switch whose operations are persistable by touch. They works on touch, and these switches are used for select mode of operations. Like in this project, we use these switches for entering the temperature and time. These switches provides a bouncing effect when a switch is pressed. Let's see about a matrix keypad. It is a combination of tactical switches in rows and column concept. These are used when more number of user inputs are required and still wanted to save some controlling input and output lines. These are commonly used in telephones, calculators, digital clockers, and etc. This is a simple circuit diagram of a matrix keypad which are connected in rows and columns. Let's see some concept about interrupts. An interrupt is a communication process setup in a microprocessor or a microcontroller in which a internal or an external device requests the MPU. MPU stands for processing unit or a microcontrolling unit to stop the process. When microprocessing unit or a microcontrolling unit acknowledges that request, then that attends to the request and goes back to the processing where it was got interrupted. Let's see some concept about polling. Polling, it is the process where the computer or a controller device waits for an external device to check the readiness of a system, often when it was in low-level hardware. Let's see the some disadvantages of polling. There will be some data loss, events occur, or poor response, less power management system. The interrupts are classified into hardware and software. While comes to hardware, they are again classified into non-maskable and maskable. While comes for a maskable, they are again classified into external interrupts and internal interrupts. The internal interrupts lies within the hardware, but the external interrupts which are comes from the external devices which are connected to the microcontroller. The software interrupts are comes from the code which we are written in software. Let's see about ISR. ISR stands for the interrupt service routine. It means it is a software routine that hardware invokes in response to the interrupt. The ISR stands to the request, attends to the request of an interrupt sourcing by the cleaning interrupt flag and should save the content that may be affected by the code in interrupt service routine. It must terminate with the instruction RETIE. When interrupts occur, the MPU completes the instruction executed, then it disables the global interrupt and enables the interrupt which was attained. Let's see some concept about a timers. Timers is an important application in an embedded system, which is default peripheral, which maintain the timing of an operation in sync with the system clock or an external clock. The timer has many applications such as measuring a time and generating the delays. The timers or counters is a software designed to count the time intervals between the events. The resolution must be a 8 or 16 bit. The TK is referred as a change from one number to another number. It may be up count or down count. The quantum which depends on the system clock setting is measure of time, which is responsible for tick. Scaling may be pre-scaled or post-scaled, which may be in the ratio of 1:1 or 1:8. The modes of timers are counters, pulse width modulation, or pulse generation. Here completes all our basic information which we are required for our project. Let's see the project demo. Before seeing the project demo, let's see what all the requirements we required for the project. First one, as we comes for a software part, we need a MPL lab, which are more required to write a code, and we need a PIXSIM lab for a virtual board, and the components which we are required, PIC16F877A module, LED module, fan module, matrix keypad module, tactical keyboard, and 16x4 display module. Let's go for our project presentation. Now we are going to see project demonstration of microwave oven in MPLAB and PIC simulator. We use MPLAB for a coding purpose and integration with a board. We use SimLab for board to display the board. Here are the header files and these are the main source files. Main.c is a main file in which we wrote all the code which is related for microwave simulation. This is PIXSIM simulator. In this PIXSIM simulator, we take a physical board in a virtual form and we insert all the codes in it and just do the simulation. First, we have to do that. Which type of simulation we have to do, which type of board we have to select, and then which type of microcontroller we are using. Here we using PIX16F877A microcontroller, and then we have to load the hexa file. After loading hexa file, it will display, and make sure that we have selected a 16 megahertz clock and the display should be a 16:4. Now the power on of microwave oven is started. In microwave oven we use four modes. First one, micro mode, grill mode, conventional mode, start mode. In micro mode, to select a micro mode, we have to press 1. Now I'm going to give a timer. I set a timer for 5 seconds and then give enter. The baking is started. After 5 seconds, the baking going to end up by displaying cooking time up. Now micro mode of microwave oven is successfully run. Now I am going to check the grill mode. To select the grill mode, I am going to press keypad button 2, and I'm going to set a timer 9 seconds and then enter. Now the simulation has been started. Meanwhile, the baking is started for a 9 seconds. It ends with cooking up time up. So the grill mode is successfully run. Now we are going to check the conventional mode of cooking. To check this, we have to press 3 and set the timer. Here we gave that the temperature should not exceed more than 250 degrees Celsius. If it exceeds more than 250 degrees Celsius, it gives a beep sound and gives the error message. For example, here I am entering 300 degree Celsius and then enters. See, it displays a invalid temperature and it again asks for the temperature. So here I am going to give 50 degrees Celsius. Now enter. The preheating has been started with 50 seconds. And it will take so long time to heat up the oven. Here my project simulation ends. And the last mode we are going to check is start mode. In this start mode, we just bake the food. We just heat up the food for a few seconds. To select the start mode, we are going to press 4. Here, it took a time of 30 seconds to just heat up the food. Yeah, there are displaying of four different functions: start, resume, pause, and stop. To start or resume, we can press 4, and to pause the microwave, we can press 5, and to stop the microwave oven, we can press 6. Here my project presentation ends. I would like to thank MTEC for giving me a great opportunity and giving me an internship based on embedded systems. Thanking you.